today we are back out in southern France, and this video is the second part of the last video I did on just finding reptiles and invertebrates and amphibians, and we're just going to be looking for whatever, really. And like the last video, there will be clips from other days and other parts of the region. Here we have a small western Montpellier snake, just a baby that I found under this rock. It just bit me. See a little blood there. And if you haven't seen the last part for this video, this is the same species of snake that I found first in that video too. But this one, like I said, is just a little baby, and that's why it's really drab and has kind of a different pattern than the adults. And the reason the snake has such a racer look to it, the large eyes, the pointed head, and the slim and long body, is because it primarily feeds on lizards, of which there are a few species here, but the most common lizard here is the Moorish gecko. This species will also feed on rodents and snakes if it gets the opportunity to. Now for the release. Just flip this large rock here. And there's another Euscorpius down here. A larger one, for sure. If I'm not mistaken, we have a death's head hawk moth caterpillar here. And this moth, the adult, after this one emerges from its pupa, has in its thoracic area a pattern that looks like a skull. It's very cool. Unfortunately, I've never seen an adult moth, but hopefully someday. And here you have the caterpillar. This has got to be my favorite species of moth, just by the caterpillar, in all of Europe. It'll probably be tough to top finding a caterpillar this cool for a very long time. You'll notice here that the horn on the posterior end is quite curled in, which is very bizarre. I'm not sure what happened here from the standpoint of evolution. I'm not sure what purpose this would serve in deterring predators, because it looks really inconspicuous as an appendage. Very strange. Whatever this plant is down here, that's what it was feeding on. So I think this guy is ready to go back on the plant here, and it should pupate sometime soon. It's getting quite cold at night, so the metabolism of this individual should really start to slow down. That is a slow worm right there. A European slow worm, Anguis fragilis. This species is definitely a must if you come to Europe. They're not really uncommon, you know, not especially rare, and in a lot of areas they're actually quite common. These mainly feed on worms, slugs, and small snails, things that are really soft, but they will also eat other small invertebrates. Despite being called slow worms, they are oftentimes quite fast on land when they're out in the open, exposed, and they are also fast swimmers. They are semi-aquatic. Down you go. Ah, look at this. Quite a few wasp generations here. Jeez, never seen a sort of colony, if you will, this large. From underneath this log right here, there's a little gecko, Tarantula mauritanica. Looks like this one wants to bite me. Yeah. Off you go. Ah, a soil centipede down here. More of these hemantarids. And this one is covered in little droplets of water. Euscorpius down there. With that same Euscorpius right there, there's actually a little baby walking around. And underneath this rock, there's another little baby right there. I don't know if it's from that scorpion specifically, but there's a chance. Oh, a smooth snake. This is a southern smooth snake, Coronella girondica, or in French, la couleuvre girondine. And this time around, if we can focus here, please. This time we have pink accents along the side of the snake here, all the way up to the head, which is classically what this snake looks like, but isn't always present on the snake. Also, comparatively with the last snake, this one's pattern is much more broken and reduced. Meanwhile, on the ventral side, we have more of a stripe going on and less chaos. Time for release. Little pill millipede buddy on the move here. These guys mostly take up the same niche that isopods do. They just feed on detritus that's usually below stones, but they do also come out at night sometimes. In this region, they definitely get much larger than the isopod counterparts that can be found under the same logs and same stones. And this one is banded orange, but oftentimes you'll see them banded yellow. I'll show you one of those as soon as I find one. And just like armadillium species, these guys will roll up into a ball. Under this rock here, we have a little armadillium possibly, or something similar. And then over here we have a little pill millipede. And this one has pretty much yellow golden banding like I was talking about. And then right in the same area, we have another one of the orange banded ones, which is the same species as the one we see here with gold. These are glomerous species. A salamander over here. A very pretty looking one at that. I have no idea which species this is, but I'm glad I found it. This is my first time ever seeing this, whatever it is. All right, well, don't wanna dehydrate it, so back you go. There is a slow worm moving around down here. Almost stepped on him when I was walking by. And this is not a European slow worm, which is Anguis virgilis. This is an Italian slow worm, Anguis vernensis. And the ones from this particular region are uniform in color. You can see this one is completely gray instead of having, you know, a dorsal stripe, median stripe, or a black underside. Along with Anguis virgilis, the European slow worm, the Italian slow worm is one of only two legless lizards that lives in France. You may have noticed this little nub right here at the base of the tail. That is because the lizard at some point dropped the tail when it was being pursued by a predator, and now it's only partially regrown. Letting this guy go in some railroad ties. European mantis down here. Ah, come back. There it is. And one more over here. I believe that neither of these females have laid their egg case yet, as their abdomen is quite plump. And it's the time of the season where you'll see some that have and some that haven't. And I have started to notice some eggs that have been laid. A little viperine snake here. I think it's puffing up its head to appear like a viper. But you won't fool me. I can see your round pupils. This is the only grass snake or snakes in the genus Natrix that is consistently common throughout the south of France. The other ones are quite spotty and oftentimes very difficult to find. Okay, little guy. I'll let you get back underneath your rock here. Here we have the burrow of a Nemesia trapdoor spider, wishbone trapdoor spider, and in this region they look a lot like Stenisa trapdoor spider burrows. And I'll see if I can open it here for you. There we go. Well, I brought my little hoe here. I probably shouldn't have said that. And I'm going to start creating a hole right in front of it, and that will make it much easier to locate the spider. I've cleared out a sort of half donut around it. I think I have to take off the entrance piece now to be able to go down deeper. And these usually don't make a burrow that goes down too deep, so I don't think I have too long before I find it. I've removed a little bit of the tunnel, and like I said, these usually don't have a very long burrow. So I can also already see the spider down there. Not sure if you can. Yeah, sort of. So I only have to go a couple more centimeters before I can poke it out. You can see it's poking out right there. You have no way of escaping me now, you might as well just come out. Got it.
This one is going to get relocated to another bank at the forest nearby.
I found our new embankment where this one can be relocated. So I'm just going to put it here. Let's put it at the spot. And this one can go. Hey, are you going to bite me or are you going to leave, rather? Come on. What are you doing? Oh, man. It doesn't want to leave my hand. I'm going to have to, like, flick it off. There we go. That works. It will now build a new trapdoor. I think I just saw a scorpion dip under here. Yeah, there's a scorpion down there. Another Euscorpius.
We've got a saddleback bush cricket hanging on this plant right here. This is Euromenus rugosicollis, an all-time favorite of mine, actually. This species is part of the family Bradyporidae, which comprises many different species of bush crickets and also armored ground crickets. And so they are omnivores.
To show you its carnivorous tendencies, I have given it a little grasshopper, and it's munching away. Whatever grasshopper I gave it just now is likely something it eats quite often in the wild, because around this area there's like hundreds of them just hopping around in the grass.
This one here is an adult female. The way we can tell is it has that egg-laying appendage on its abdomen there, the one that looks like a sword. While we're talking about this ovipositor, the way that this genus can be told apart from Ephippiger, another similar genus, is they have a short curved ovipositor, while Ephippiger's is longer and more straight. We're in late October now, so sun is cold and rain is hard, and it won't be much longer until you won't be able to see these guys anymore. This is a perennial species, so along with many other insects that live around here, it won't make it past the winter.
Oh, one of these little toads here. I'm not really certain what I'm looking at, but these are quite cool. And here's our habitat. Back you go. Stay in there. Oh, a little scolopendra here. It's leaving. There it is. That's a little baby scolopendra cingulata. It's leaving down a hole. I'll leave it alone. We have quite a vibrant swallowtail caterpillar here. And if I rub it near the head, it should have these little yellow appendages that come out. There they are. See that? So this caterpillar eats plants like anise and fennel and other things that are very similar, like dill. And those are very strong smelling plants. And so they retain those chemicals in whatever those appendages near the head are. And they can rub them on predators, and it smells very, very strong. It's not doing it anymore, but you saw them before. Here we have a baby southern smooth snake, Coronella geronica. Let's see the lines. Yep, there they are. This one probably less than 15 centimeters. Really not that long at all. And I could be mistaken, but I think it has something in its belly. And because this is a baby, I should be able to get the head to make a sort of diamond shape. Sometimes they'll puff up their jaws to make themselves look like a little viper. And it's somewhat convincing, but it looks like this one isn't doing it. Here we have a conehead mantis. Right in there. Man, I love these guys. Alright. Here you are. You can tell that, more or less, they are evolved to look like plants similar to thistle, or thistles themselves. So good plant that this particular mantis has chosen. I don't know what it's doing on the ground now. I'll try to put it back. This Euscorpius turgistinus down here that has just caught an ant in the late male has all this white stuff on its turgites, its dorsal side. And that's because it had babies recently. And those are the molts of the first instar babies. And right there you can see all the babies just crawling around. There must be 20 or so of them.
Little toad hopping around here. And as usual, I have no idea what species it is. Very small though. Off you go.
Well, that will be all for this video. So thank you for watching.